And now we will learn how to check results and find mistakes. We have already learned that in any report, you can adjust the date range to see how you did during a specific time period. We also learned you can double-click any number that represents a balance or a summary to see every transaction that adds up to that balance. And the list of transactions you get when you double-click is called a detail. And we saw that in previous videos. But what you did not yet learn is that there's a report called the journal, and it is one of the best things you can use to find and fix mistakes. The journal is the only report that shows every transaction since the beginning of the file. It's also the only report that shows the transactions in the order in which they were entered into the computer, regardless of date. Let's take a look at the journal. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Journal. Notice when the journal opens up, the date choice is month to date. I happen to be recording this video on June 14th of 2016. That's why my journal opened from June 1 to June 14. To really benefit from what the journal has to offer, you must click the date pull-down arrow, scroll all the way to the top, and click the choice All. This way, the journal is showing the results of all transactions, regardless of date. Notice it has the June 1 deposit from Molly's Saloon, the June 2nd from the Beer and Go, and this is every transaction we did in every previous video in the order in which it was entered into the computer, which, by the way, is not always the same as date order. Notice there's an extra column here for transaction number. This way, no matter what document number you put, or no matter what date you put, you will always know what transaction that was in the order in which it was put into the computer with all the other transactions. So if you were putting in multiple types of transactions in one session, and you put in many different checks, deposits, and credit card charges, then you suddenly got distracted and you did not know where you left off, you could open this journal and you would know exactly where you left off, and you would know exactly what was entered and what was not yet entered. There is something important that you should do to the journal before you save the journal to the icon bar. You should add a column for the date entered or modified. This way you can see the date that you actually recorded the transaction into QuickBooks, regardless of the date that you actually told QuickBooks was associated with the transaction. For example, this particular transaction has the date of June 9th, but it might not have been entered into QuickBooks on June 9th. We can add a column so we can find out the date the transaction was entered, and that column will be next to the date that the transaction actually happened. From the top left of the journal, click Customize Report. In the Modify Report window, there are four tabs. Make sure the Display tab is the one that's selected. When you go down to the bottom left, you have a choice of adding or removing columns. In our case, we will click this one, Entered Last Modified. Make sure the computer places the check mark in the margin when you click. After you click OK, you will notice on the journal we now have a new column for entered slash last modified. Now we know that even though the date of this particular transaction is June 6th, and we actually paid Dr. Kirk on June 6th, we actually recorded this into QuickBooks on June 11th. That will be very helpful to you when you're recording large amounts of transactions and trying to find something that you entered. Now that the journal looks the way it should, we're going to save it to the icon bar. Go to the top left and click View, add journal to the icon bar, and click OK. Now, if you close it out, if you can remember to open it only from the icon bar, it will look exactly the way it looked at the moment that we saved it to the icon bar. Putting the wrong date when you enter a transaction is the hardest mistake to find. That's because most QuickBooks reports show transactions in date order. A date mistake is the hardest to find because things are usually displayed in date order. If you can display the transactions in the order in which they were entered into the computer, then you will find your date mistake. You can resort any register to become order entered. For example, if I open the M&T register and I change the date for this June 11 transaction to June 2nd, as soon as I save it, it'll jump up into this position between June 1st and June 3rd. Let's take a look. I'm going to click here, change it to June 2nd, then when I click record, I get the normal warning message that we usually get when we make a change. Then when I click yes, notice the Citibank card transaction dated June 2nd now has jumped up into its position and date order between June 1st and June 3rd. It's the same transaction, all we did was change the date. And because the register is sorted in date order, it moved it up to the top. However, if we leave the incorrect date, but we go down here and change the sort to order entered, notice that the transaction comes back down here. So we can see June 1, June 3, June 4, and then June 2nd, because even though it's dated June 2nd, it was entered after the others. And if you change the sort to order entered, that will reveal the fact that it was entered after the others, regardless of date. Before I leave the window, I'm going to change it back to its correct date and click record. I again get the warning message, and then I click yes. Before you do your exercise in the next video, I need to make one last point about using the registers. You cannot change the column of the money amount after you saved a transaction. If you made the mistake of putting the money amount in the wrong column, the only thing you can do is delete the transaction and re-enter it. The reason for this is because when you put money in a particular column in the register, QuickBooks sees this as a certain type of transaction. But if you put the money amount in the different column, QuickBooks actually believes it's a completely different type of transaction and would go in a different window. When you record something in the register and you put the money in the payment column, QuickBooks has determined once you save the transaction with the money in the payment column that this is a check, which is a specific type of transaction. This very same check could have been recorded the exact same way in a different window in QuickBooks, and the result would be the same, but would have to be the checks window. However, if you record a transaction and save the money amount in this other column, QuickBooks believes that this is a completely different type of transaction called a deposit, and the result would be the same as if you recorded it in this other window in QuickBooks. You are not able to change a check into a deposit or a deposit into a check. So when you look at the register, you see transactions in the same window with the money amounts in the different column. But when QuickBooks looks at the register, it sees any transaction with the money amount saved here as this type of transaction, which is a completely different type of transaction than the transactions that are saved with the money amount in this deposit column, that you could have also recorded in this make deposit window, and you would get the same result. So, what do you do if you make that mistake? Well, again, you would have to delete that transaction and re-enter it properly. Don't worry, there will always be a permanent record of whatever was deleted in this report, the voided deleted transaction detail. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Voided Deleted Transaction Detail. Of course, you need to adjust the pull-down date option and choose the very top choice, All. Then you would get the results of every deleted transaction that you have deleted since you created this file. Since this report is so important, you should then add it to the icon bar. From the main menu, click View, Add Voided Deleted Transaction to the icon bar, and then click OK. Please remember, if a transaction is not listed in the journal, then it will definitely be listed on the voided and deleted transaction report. Please remember, if a transaction number is missing in the journal, that means it's deleted and you would find it on the voided deleted transaction detail.